أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Dear students of 11th class السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته I hope that you will be safe at your homes Stay home, stay safe Dear students, you know that we are discussing the kingdom Protesta, and we have studied that this kingdom Protesta has been divided into three major groups, and the first group was the Protestant or the photosynthetic protists, or we can call them as Protestant algae. And under the Protestant algae, we have thrown light upon the dinoflagellates, euglenoids, and diatoms. Now, the second group of this kingdom are the psyllium molds. So our today's topic is psyllium molds, which is the second group of this kingdom Protista. After that, we will study the third group of this kingdom Protista, that is the protozoan protists. So our today's topic is psyllium molds. These psyllium molds are also called fungi-like protists or decomposer protists. So this is the second name of these psyllium molds. You can call them also fungi-like protists or decomposer protists. So what are the general characters of these psyllium molds? We will discuss those general characters of psyllium molds one by one. The first general character of these psyllium molds is that these psyllium molds are organisms which share the characters of both plants and animals, thus are commonly called fungus animals. So this is the first general character of these psyllium molds, that these organisms have both the characters of plants as well as animals. So what are the characteristics of plants and animals? Those both characters are found in these psyllium molds, and due to this peculiarity, these are commonly called fungus animals. So this is the first general character of these psyllium molds. Now the second general character of these psyllium molds is that they are terrestrial and occur in shady, moist areas. They are terrestrial, means they live on land, or they occur on land where there is shady, moist places. That means in Kashmiri we can call it yatasan zaminas man srej zaminas beya shuhul. So this is the second character of these psyllium molds, that they live on land and occur in shady, moist areas. Now the third general character of these psyllium molds is the vegetative parts do not possess cell wall. When the psyllium molds grow, vegetative parts do not possess the cell wall. So in the beginning, they have no cell wall. However, the reproductive structures possess the cell wall. So you should remember here that the vegetative parts of the psyllium molds have no cell wall, but the reproductive structures of psyllium molds possess cell walls. This is the third general character. Now the fourth general character is the organisms occur as slimy mass during the vegetative phase. During the vegetative phase, they seem to be slimy as a slimy mass, and due to this peculiar character, they are called the slime molds. Slime molds during the vegetative phase occur as slimy mass, thus these are called slime molds. Number fifth general character is the protoplasm is differentiated into two portions, the outer unucleated, which is also called haloplasm, and the central nucleated portions. So the protoplasm of slime molds have the two regions. Outer region is unucleated haloplasm, while as the central portion is nucleated, and that nucleated portion contain the hundreds to thousands nuclei. Chlorophylls have been found absent in the slime molds. Now the sixth general character is about the nutrition. The mode of nutrition in slime molds is saprotrophic. That means they do not have the photosynthetic nutrition, but they are having the saprotrophic nutrition. A few species of these slime molds are parasitic on algae. Some are parasitic on algae, but largely nutrition is saprotrophic. Now the seventh general character is these slime molds show amoeboid movement. As the movement is found in amoeba protozoa, which is an animal, and that amoeba moves with the help of pseudopodia, phallospherian ko bolte hain. These slime molds also show the amoeboid movement, yani ki amoeba like movement. The movements which are found in amoeba, those are also found in these slime molds, and these slime molds move by the formation of pseudopodia, jinko bolte hain phallosphete bhi, and those pseudopodia are also present in the amoeba, and the amoeba moves with the help of pseudopodia also, and these slime molds also form the pseudopodia for their movement. Now the reproduction. Asexual reproduction occurs by fragmentation. Asexual reproduction in slime molds occurs by fragmentation, sclerotia, and by the formation of sporangia. Sporangia contain the spores. So the asexual reproduction occurs by fragmentation, sclerotia, and by the formation of sporangia. Now the sexual reproduction occurs by the fusion of gametes. Two types of gametes fuse with one another and the sexual reproduction occurs. Thus the sexual reproduction occurs by the fusion of gametes, and the mode of sexual reproduction is isogamous or anisogamous. That means either the similar types of gametes fuse with one another, or the different types of gametes fuse with one another, and thus the sexual reproduction occurs. So this was all about the slime molds, their general characters. I hope you have now understood the general characters of these slime molds, and with which we have completed these slime molds. And now we will, in our next lecture, we will move towards the third group of these protistan algae. Those are called the protozoan protists, and that will be our next lecture tomorrow, inshallah. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you very much.